remember, it's like the only people who were ever scared of the dog, and she's like,
Hi, how are you all doing? Colin here, this is Shine Automotive, and today we're back on with the KA. What we're going to be doing today is we're going to be changing a lot of stuff in the dash, putting a temperature gauge in, putting a boost gauge in, redirecting the fuel lines. What else are we going to do? Getting a new washer bottle fitted. So there's loads of little fiddly bits, redirecting the water coolant lines. So yeah, let's jump into this one. And if you're new to the channel, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you're a returning subscriber, hello. Let's jump straight into this one. So we have this boost gauge here that I bought off Amazon, and I bought the most complex one going, so that's going to keep Sam busy. And then we had, on one of the other scrap KAs that we've had before, we've got a A-pillar temperature gauge, so we'll have a go at getting that plumbed in as well. Sam's going to have a go at removing that the correct way. And that's part of it out. And just like that, she's out. How did you like that?
That's actually how far to you to do it now.
Is it? Is that how it says in the data?
Perfect.
Yeah, well, like you say, if we've got it all wet where it is now, it's going to be easier to share the power off the two as well, isn't it? Mm-hmm. The only thing with it is you want that other bit because you want the clips off it.
What?
You want the clips off it to fiberglass onto here.
They kind of broke. I've got them bits.
Yeah.
Well, no, it passes that in a minute. It'll. God, it's proper homemade, isn't it?
It's just a fiberglass mould, isn't it? Without any of the clips, that's normally the case. It's not going to fit like a glove, is it?
Bad though, is it?
Is it not?
I'm sick of it, so I'm going to get away with it. This will hold a lot of it.
Yeah, and you could get a little screw down there though, couldn't you?
It's not mint there, is it? But it's all covered, look, so.
A bit of sticker flex in there. What I want to do though is that is whip the gauge out and I'll just paint that something black because it looks a mess, doesn't it? Nah. Rubbish, that carbon fibre effect stuff.
That's real carbon fibre.
It's not.
Yes, it is.
So I'm going to have to get this intercooler pipe off. Drill a hole in the side of the boost pipe, tap that in. If you don't tap in very well, I'll just do a nice bit of weld around there. It needs just quick sand down and paint up as well. So we'll get cracked on with that one. So that's where we're plumbing for the boost gauge. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to make a little bracket so the intercooler pipe will just sit down with that part from the focus. The Mark 1 Focus diesel, these bits we've robbed off. I'm just going to do a little bracket so it just pulls it down, and where that flat bit is, that's where the bonnet sits down. It doesn't even touch it. I've been quite lucky with that one. Yeah, I'll make that do. So we've just chucked some paint on them just to make them look better. That was quite rough, that carbon fibre, fiberglass rubbish.
And then obviously where I put, made the bracket to hold the boost pipe down, and then where we get the feed for the boost gauge. So I let them dry for a bit. Ooh, very nice. Is that really how hot it is though?
5 degrees. No, it's a standard thing, isn't it, when anything's not working. Warning. Hot. Thought it would have gone up. Shit. Boiled over, mate.
Oh no. It's cooked it. You've cooked it, Sam.
Well, at least when it works.
Yep, sound.
So you don't get that with the cheap gauge.
Is it proper smart like?
Watch.
Watch. Watch. So Sam's halfway through with the wiring up now. How are you finding it, buddy?
Quite easy.
Finding it quite easy, so there we go. And hopefully we'll have all this working by the end of the day. What do you say, Sam?
I say it's KAK.
KAK. Yeah. We've got to name it, in fact.
Yeah,
cat. Well, I say cat.
I say cat.
KA Turbo.
KAK.
So KAT.
CAC.
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 What, because you think it's CAC?
Well, we are, aren't we?
Oh, yeah, but everyone says that some of this stuff can't be done and we're trying to do it cheaply. Without doing out and then you haven't even swapped the ECU yet to see the difference. I think we'll wait till that's all done and we'll do a boost, standard boost test. I know it's not going to be going down the road, but we can do a boost test with it on the ramp, then put the 1600 ECU on it and see if it makes any difference. And then if it makes any difference, change the pressure regulator and see if it makes any difference there. But then when we can get round to get it MOT'd, we can start doing road tests with it as well, can't we? Yeah.
You've got stuff working?
Some of it.
Some of it.
Ready?
Yeah. What were we doing?
Checking that it goes to zero. Yes, that's it.
Is it done?
Wiring under the bonnet.
Yep.
Pipe under the bonnet.
Yep.
Well, that's set to zero, so I'm happy with that. I'll fit it in there now.
Yeah.
It's worth every penny, isn't it? Now, when you look at
the quality of it.
Yep. Compared to the shit that would have put in it.
Sometimes it's worth spending a bit more money on a bit, isn't it?
Well, you didn't have a clue, did you?
So no, I'll just click back now. I thought it was 13 quid, not 31 quid. So there we go. Right, so we've got the rocker cover off, and I think I'm going to start removing get the valve out of the way, remove these two pipes, and sort of start having a look at the fuel lines as well. And then hopefully the heat tape will be turning up for the rocker cover. So I've got a few bits to do with the rocker cover to clean up. So yeah, I think we'll fuel lines and water lines start getting them rerouted now. So I've got the pipes off where the heater matrix valve used to land like that, but obviously the pipes run right where we're going to start ticking the manifold for the turbo. So I've undone it, taken a bit of wire off, and I'm going to change it, bring it over to here, and then just adapt a couple of the pipes. One of the pipes lies perfect already. So do that, get that in there, get that in there, put a screw down in there, so that brings it. The plug's still under the guard, so it's not going to get affected by water. And then I can bring both pipes down this way and into the thermostat housing. Yeah, boy. So, I've used
all the original pipes to get as far done as here now. We're just chopping them down and bringing them around. But what I'm going to have to do is go get another one of these. Now that sits nice, there's no kinks there. And I'll bring the other one along, cable tape, that might bring it under. And route round here, route down and around or something, to get onto there. And then I will heat tape these anyway. When the heat tape arrives, I'll clean all the pipe off and heat tape it up first, and probably I'm just going to go a bit over the top of the heat tape, so then at least it's doing half the job it's meant to be doing. So I need to go and find another one of these pipes off another one of the scrap K's at the top. So yeah, I'll go and do that now and I'll be back in a second.
Taking it to bits.
Why?
I don't like it.
Like what?
Any of it.
What, the clocks on the screen?
I don't like that clock. I don't like these clocks. It's white or crap.
What are you going to do, like?
Fine, so find some in the scrap.
We could have some dark ones in the 1600K, in all fairness. Maybe look better, won't they? It'll match with the clocks you've put in. And in all fairness, Sam, that's a proper neat tidy job to say. We've just done it with one gauge and then a bit of scrap there up on your car, like. Very nice. You happy with how it's coming together?
Oh, it's alright.
It's alright?
Yeah. Yeah, get it out of my face.
Get it out of your face! Yeah.
Messing around. I don't like green. Ford are obsessed with green and I fucking hate green.
Ford are obsessed with green what?
Green lights and bulbs everywhere. I don't like green.
What have you done to the clocks, like? You took the clocks out of the other car to get the black clocks.
Mm-hmm.
Which suits with all the gauge and stuff there, doesn't it?
Yep.
Have a look at your fancy light then in the clocks.
Broken.
Come on now. So we're getting there now.
It's kept the mileage.
It's kept the mileage.
Yeah.
Right, so you know we swapped the clocks over and the mileage must be stored in the ECU and it's kept the correct mileage. Do you know what's the issue?
What?
Look at that steering wheel, that old plasticky steering wheel.
I hate plastic steering wheels.
Yeah, but you know them sports KAs, don't you?
Yeah.
And you know we've got that sports KA up there. I've got you a present there.
Could have cleaned it first.
Like. Well, I'm going to give it a clean now. Yeah,
thanks, mate.
So. Look how better that's going to look compared to that thing that's on there.
Look how much better it's going to look.
Okay, look how...
Does it have a leather airbag though or not?
No, they're the same. Same style plastic airbags. You have a bit of fluff on you.
It's not from Spider, I'm not...
No, it's not Spider. Look at that, put them side by side, let's have a look. Are they bigger?
I think it is. It's bigger.
Looks nicer.
It's massive. Is it over wagon?
No, it's over sports car. It's just because it's got them leather things in it. Same thing.
Who took this to bits?
I didn't take it to bits. No, I'll swap over from the other one. So I'll let you get on with that now.
Thanks, mate.
It's all right, mate. Not a problem. So what he's done, he's swapped. Took the white clocks out. There you go. We're flashing. For them, which looks loads more stealthy, and then it sort of matches in with the boost cage that we fit in. And then he's changed the centre clock there. And now he's going to do the radio. We haven't, unfortunately, got the bit at the bottom, but it's not a massively different colour. It's a slightly different shade, but knowing us lot, we'll come across one very shortly. So yeah, Massive difference.
And you like it, don't you?
I do.
Yes, he does.
So the 1600 steering wheel is on, and the clocks, and the actual time clock as well in the middle, and the radio, but the only thing that was missing out of it is a bit of a bottom. I'm sure one will come across because it just makes it all look quite stealthy. So I'm well happy with that. Sam's well happy with it as well, aren't you?
Buzzing, mate.
Buzzing. I might as well go get that proper pipe. Because we need the washer bottle, don't we?
Yeah, yeah.
Off it. So I might as well go and start doing it. Alright, mate.
Hey, guys.
Right, I've got a present. Well, I have. I've got your unbroken screen wash bottle, and I've got your pipe, seeing as you...
I don't want your pipe.
You redirected the pipe because I did a rubbish job and you made it look better.
It did, like.
Not your pipe, not your problem. Yeah. Well, it is your problem now. So we've got the heater matrix pipes moved from where they used to be. Obviously they used to come across, right across here, so Sam's routed them. They go down, round, and then they come back up here, which will run each year. So what we're going to do now is get these fuel pipes out of the way. We're going to cut into the metal pipe down to the bottom with a brake pipe flarer, with a brake pipe cutter, pipe cutter, and then we're going to bring them up. Well out the way, along here, nice and tidy, and replace them so they're not going straight across where the exhaust downpipe will be. And as you can see now, we're getting plenty of room to start going for the exhaust. Also, we heat tape a load of these pipes up, and we tape these pipes up, and then we've got to route out where we're going to work out where to route the coil pack and where to route the pipes. This is the only one that really is close to the exhaust, but we've got an exhaust turbo blanket coming as well. So it's starting to get tidy as well, things are getting rerouted. Got the new washer bottle in, and obviously all the inside bits are done. The brake servo vacuum pipe has been moved now, so that doesn't come across there. It just comes up in between the coolant pipes and goes straight in to the servo. So yeah, it's getting there now. Right, well, Sam's got the fuel lines all done and the breather pipes, so now they all come round there, round the battery, and then they drop down into where I cut the pipe. So now we're getting really, really clear space for starting to get the exhaust done. So all the coolant pipes are good, everything, you know, we're getting all these spaces, just a couple of wires to move here, to change, but it's looking really good now. Right, I'm just editing this video and it is full. So instead of waiting till next weekend, tune in tomorrow night at 6:30. We're going to do a double special this weekend. So give it a comment down below. Smash that like button. If you want to watch the rest of the playlist, it should be up here. And we'll see you tomorrow night, 6:30. Have a beautiful time. Stay safe. Boom.